Today I'm going to determine or try and predict the fatigue life of a part based on a strain gauge measurement. I'm going to use Simcenter Test Lab Neo, go into the general processing folder here and open up something called Process Designer to do that. I'll pick the universal view where I can design a process. If I don't want to see this startup screen, I can turn it off down here. And once this is loaded, I have a few areas, a data selection area, a process builder, a display area. I'm going to select my project that has my strain data in it and open it. And once the project is open, I can navigate into it and look at the measurements. Here I see my strain gauge measurement over time. Looks nice and severe, so I'm curious what the fatigue life will be. I'll put that strain gauge into the input basket for processing. So if I look now, I have in my input basket one strain gauge measurement. And then to process it, I'll go over here to my method library, and I can scroll down, and there's a lot of different functions I can do. I'm going to pick one called strain life, and strain life will predict how long something will last given this strain time history. If you can't find strain life in the method library, make sure that under File, Add-ins, you have the fatigue life analysis add-in on and available. Now let's take a look at some of the properties here of the strain life method. You can see here input type is set to load. I want that to be elastic plastic strain because I have a strain gauge input. The influence factor, I can scale that strain gauge measurement up or down if I want to be more or less conservative. I'll just use the strain gauge measurement as it is. Now I'll pick the material data. And there's some materials that are included here. If I wanted to add my own material, I could edit or create one based on the uniform material law. You can see that some of the things I need are like the Manson-Coffin-Morrow strain life curve. I need a Ramberg-Osgood relation for my material and some limits, etc. I'll pick my material, and then I have a second selection called the method parameter. This method parameter lets me pick how I want to handle the mean stress of each and every cycle, because it can be different for each one, and that can have an effect on the life. I'll pick the Morrow method for handling the mean stress, which includes both damage from compression and from tension. And now with both of those selected, I'll go ahead and hit run here, and it's calculating the results. The results temporarily will be put in this active analysis. So if I look there, you can see I have some results, including the original time history. But I also have something called a life curve. And if I look at that and double click, I have a histogram of all the cycles that were in that strain gauge time history. And then I have some other curves. These are called life curves. And this dot over here is, if I scroll down, this cycle count here is the number of cycles until it fails. And that would be, and this is the number of cycles in the original time history. In fact, I could actually put on a cursor and I see the number of cycles here and then the number of cycles until it fails. If I double click back here, that ratio, if I go to the life statistics display, what this design point blocks number shows me is 1,480. My part could withstand 1,480 repeats of that strain gauge time history before it would fail, like cracks or unable to carry load or something like that. Now, when I was looking at these life curves, you may have noticed that there was actually two sets of curves. If I right-click here and I go to Options, I can turn on something called the creator. That's the name of the process that made this. And you'll see that some of these are weighted and some are not. So these are without any mean stress correction, just straight up strain life. The weighted have the mean stress influence applied. In order to do that, we had to calculate something called a damage parameter, or P. And so we had a P histogram instead of a strain cycle histogram. We also had to calculate something called a PN curve. The value P comprehends both the strain and the stress of each cycle and of the material. So that's what this weighted means. And in fact, when I'm looking in this pivot table, you see there's two here. If I clicked on this and I picked creator, I could actually see both the results weighted here and the results without weighting applied by switching on creator. So you can put it in the legend or you put it on in the pivot table. Hopefully that made sense, and thank you very much for watching. If I like the results, I hit accept and they will be stored in my project in a new run here. And in this new run, I have both the original strain gauge and the processed results. Thanks.